Welcome to this session on lessons learned on COVID-19. So I am your moderator. My name is Ravi Kiran. I am the co-founder and director for TuduBuddy. This session is brought to you by TuduBuddy Limited and Learn to Lead. Today we have four speakers on the panel. So about the TuduBuddy, this is a online platform which is working with the schools and parents in assessing and finding the learning difficulties and finding the gaps and then helping them. This is an AI-based platform and available from www.todobuddy.com. So TuduBuddy do conduct weekly championships to compete across the globe. It happens every Sunday evening, 7:30 p.m. India time. Of course, it reflects to all the other time zones. And TuduBuddy has presence in UAE, India, and UK. They just started stepping into Germany as well. That's about TuduBuddy. So as I said, we have panel has four people today. So the first speaker is Dilip Kumar, who is a principal in Meghalaya for CMCL Vidyabharti. And the next speaker we have is Hema Surpaneni, who is a principal for Epistomo Global School. She is based in Hyderabad. And third speaker we have today is Ms. Gurleen Kokar, who is based in Chandigarh. She is a international psychologist. And I will get into detailed description a little later, just before her session. And the last speaker we have today is Harshi Afsar. She is based in Hyderabad. She is mainly coming from educational background and educational and entrepreneurship. Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Okay, perfect. Loud and clear. Good. So, Dilip, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Perfect. Let me introduce about Dilip. So, Dilip has basically been born and brought up in Bokaro Steel City. He has a master's degree in education and also an MPhil degree. He started teaching in 1991. He worked in Assam Valley School and the Lawrence School. And he also worked as a principal in Disha School and GD Goenka International School. And he has been a CAS coordinator. He also has attended various international events in Phuket and Chittagong. So he also has a few awards on his name. One is Effective Principals of 2019. This is by Education Today. And he's also got an award from Pandit Madan Mohan Malaviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching, and also has award and Avantiyaka Abdul Kalam Award for Principal for in Rashtriya Mahatma Samman 2019. So can I request you to start, Dilip?
Yes. Good evening, everyone. Today I feel, thank you very much, TuduBuddy, that you have given an opportunity to feel like world is one family. Sarve bhavantu sukhina, sarve shantu niramaya. So we pray for the well-being of all of us. And came across through the weekly championship. And I'm very fortunate that being in countryside in Meghalaya, in India, and we are able to compete with, take part with others. But the lesson learned from COVID-19, what we are doing something different, what we have got something different. Initially, we have many apprehensions, even teachers, because this location, network, there were a lot of issues. And how this will be possible that the complete class, okay, we can include technology, we can take Zoom classes for time being, but student started missing school, teacher started missing school. So the first challenge was with us is emotional well-being. And we started doing something different. Because you see, in the classroom, what you usually do, though we tell that, you see, it is not lecture method classes, it is not chalk and talk, but usually it is. The fact is entirely different because the system is such and we are not ready to come out from the tunnel vision. We are not ready to accept that, okay, there are many fields where you can grow. Ultimately, what we do, we go for the IIT preparation, coachings, and that mindset we are not ready to come out. Even our board, CBSE or ICSE or the Government of India, they talk, but they are not ready. They everything is exam oriented, everything is lesson oriented, lecture oriented. So this COVID has given us an opportunity to look beyond. The first thing was the well-being. So we have taken many sessions for the teacher training, how to go about it. And we were fortunate that teacher accepted in a very short span of time. And the student also started joining this class. But then this, to make the class more interesting, we included many things. We gave a lot of creative challenges to a student, not based on the lesson. So they started making video, they started developing messages, they started giving messages for how to keep yourself protected. And we took in between help from many technological institutions like online learning. We take from mathematics, Manga High. Our students started participating with the Study Buddy. We had MindSpark, included MindSpark. And we also insisted upon not teaching about these five subjects, but we have talked about meditation and we started talking about yoga. So this yoga and meditation, not only for the student, but I felt and we witnessed that many of our parents also participated in our classroom when the teacher's yoga teacher was taking class. It was very nice. And yoga teacher not only did this class, talked about the physical health, she started talking about the value of food and medicinal plants. So they were very keen, noted down. So these activities, what we feel now, this is the time we learned about the blended learning. This is the time we learned about that we need teachers who have got excellent communication skill. They will survive. The teacher who can think beyond the classroom, teacher who can offer more and more creative opportunity for children. We started one unique plan, story writing in this situation. And I feel this was a very good opportunity for a student. They participated in very good number. And then we publish our glimpses usually. And this time what has happened, in the addition to these glimpses, we also published video glimpse, which is available on our YouTube site, where children has given message, parent has started participating. So learning from this COVID is, yes, this also we took as opportunity, we took as learning new things. Though it was challenging, we do miss our school, we do miss our children, but we are not having option. And one best part, which I feel that we can do this, that in the classroom, the class teachers, they played a very significant role in having day-to-day connection. They spoke to each and every student over telephone. So that was there, okay, the teacher is calling to a small number of their classroom. So we started that contact was there through telephone. It was not in the classroom. We missed assembly, we missed many activities, playgrounds we missed. But at the same time, we have learned that in coming days, but we have certain limitation. Limitation about we are located in countryside. So what happened when 40 minutes gets over, then we get a message that, okay, your session gets over. So the class is not complete, but then we started using WhatsApp group. We have created the classroom groups and where we share the assignment, where we take the feedback from the students. But most of students, they do have this present scenario, everybody is having Android phones. But at the same time, you also have the parents because we have a multicultural community here, and we have clientele from we have the students from manager family, local children, and we have from the workers children. So there was problem of Android phones, there was problem of data. So what they started doing, they understood that okay, everybody needs this. Earlier we used to tell, don't take mobile phones, are not allowed in the school. Now we are telling that it is one of the important aspect, the important tool to get in touch with students. So this mobile phone became, but I think in coming days what we will have to do, or the government at higher level, because this ultimately education is a state subject, and government will have to include a team, Google Meet and all Zoom application as resources, and will have to provide in wider scale, whether it is a private school or it is a government school or a public school. So government will have to adopt this, and this will become so, if lockdown is over and everything becomes normal, which we hope so, by maintaining a good life, or life with a spiritual life, and doing yoga and doing meditation and thinking about helping each other. So things will become normal. But one thing will be there, which we have learned from this, that okay, if in coming days also, in a week, at least if we are calling a student on alternative days, or we are dividing, making student section, we are having less number of a student due to the distance they have to maintain. So what will happen, that 3 days we will have that Google Meet or Zoom classes or online classes. So technology now will become, it will increase from 25 to 50%, not 100%, 100% I don't think so. The teacher role will be there. So we have a lot of learning, we have a lot of obstacles, but I'm very fortunate, I'm very thankful to my team, teachers and Star Cement management, that they are ready to support, they are ready to support, and we are also ready to support those parents, but we are still betting that let us come back, let us go back to the school and take safety measures, take precautions, and hope things will be normal very soon. And do something creative, do something beyond knowledge and understanding, because knowledge sharing, all these things are available everywhere. So we have to look for the teachers who are having out of the box thinking, who believe in activities, who give challenges, who participate, and who all are ready. And caring teachers, and sincere about the well-being of teachers and all school, whole school community, and that life is also become now less materialistic. Our expenses has come down. Nowhere to go outside, not to purchase much, not to visit. So yes, this also has happened. So lot of. Where we need to help each other, we need to support each other, but we need to talk to our student, talk to our family members at least once, and think something always innovative, do some innovations, and bring it into the classroom, and recognize those students who are not only good in a particular subject or particular field. Give them recognition, those who are very good in art also, art and craft also, they have done wonderful. If I can see that there are a lot of things which is happening, and then parents are involved, they are making video films and sharing with us. We started our YouTube channel. So these online classes, and they are sharing the photographs, and teachers also have done a lot of. They utilize this time, because usually we were going for the vacation in the month of June. So teacher started attending many online classes, and I'm very much thankful to many institution has come up and offered the courses during this time, and they learned how to be online teacher using different software, Microsoft Excel. They are very good program. Many webinars they have attended. They are also learning and sharing with us. So this learning and sharing has become very useful this time, and many institutions have come up with many plan, and we also had some of the session beyond this. For the student, I told you that we had a yoga session, we had some activities, we have given challenges for writing stories and creating their art and craft work. But we had, in collaboration with the Fortis Hospital, we have one of the top most leading doctor and psychologist who taken session for the students and the parents. So, and we are also working. So we got a little bit more time, it is not less. And thank you very much for hearing me, listening me with patience. And I would love to hear from you. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Dilip. So it was very insightful and really thoughtful. I think, you know, there's a lot of creativity and how you're doing the things, a lot of positive to take from these uncertain situations. I think I would like to give an example from my side that my daughter is most excited only one time in a week, which is Thursday afternoon, because she has a Zoom session with her class teacher. So all the children come and they're so excited about that. And she really waits for her next week, you know.
So
I mean, it's unfortunate. I think you really touched upon a lot of positives about cutting down the expenses and really nice. And I hope it doesn't reflect to the salaries of the teachers because they're really working so hard.
Yes, that also I want to mention one more thing, that we are very fortunate because we get support from Star Cements. And not only we are giving the 100%, we have not deducted any amount. And we are giving, earlier we used to give on 10th, we are giving now on 4th of month, every month. So from that aspect, teachers, but only thing is, some teachers, they feel now they have enriched themselves, they have got a lot of training. So they are also enriching, and there are many offers coming to our teachers.
Okay.
So three of our teachers, they have got almost double salary and they got offer. So that another problem we are also waiting for, that once lockdown is over, because the movement is not, interest rate movement is not allowed. So that is also happening. So teachers are also growing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's really a first-hand experience. Very nice, Dilip. I hope it will not trouble you, teachers leaving you at this stage. So they, I would like to, yeah, sorry, Dilip, yeah, please go on.
Yeah, well, no, what they were trained recently. They were put into a situation where they have to learn. And they learned and they realized that, okay, this is not only for the, within the Meghalaya or Shillong we can teach. We can teach the student abroad.
Okay.
We can take classes. Now, so this, so they know they are now this power of technology also, that we are in touch with the people from abroad and everywhere. We are all together here.
Yep.
So we wish each other all good wishes and health, and they should be safe. They should be healthy, happy. So this is wishes from everyone.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, Dilip. Dilip, for all your thoughts and what is going on the ground. Bye for now. Take care,
thank
all
you
of you.
Thank you. And Mr. Ravi, the whole Tudu Buddy team, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Hi, all speakers. I loved your talk, Mr. Dilip, Parshya, and Gurleen. Loved your insight. Thank you so much.
Thanks. Thanks a lot. Stay connected. Stay blessed, everyone.
And Tudu Buddy, keep going up with the good work. That
yeah, sure.
That's what I'd like thank to say. You. In times like this, we need platforms like yours.
Thank you. Thank you, Arshia. Sure, we'll do our best. Yeah.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Evening. Bye-bye.